The prominence of non-objective law and the increasing amount of control that the government has over the economy seem to have come along together. Is there any significance in the fact that the worst non-objective laws have to do with the regulation of economic affairs?
Oh, yes, of course. Because, strictly speaking, for a tyranny, any kind of tyranny, to establish itself, non-objective laws are required. No matter how severe a form of government you might have, if its laws, its edicts are objective, such a government is not a tyranny. It does not have an arbitrary power over the citizens. And you will observe in all histories that there never has been such a combination. A strict objective code of rules and governmental tyranny. In order to be a tyranny, the essence of tyrannical power is the arbitrary power. To be tyrannical, government power has to be arbitrary. And the only means to an arbitrary rule are non-objective laws and also retroactive laws, or ex post facto, which means a law passed retroactively. So an action which you took while it was legal becomes illegal, let's say a year or two later, and you are penalized for it. Now that is typical non-objective law. It is incidentally forbidden in the Constitution explicitly, and yet it is being practiced on a wider and wider scale constantly.